Hello, and welcome back to the Adventures of Maddog Williams. Let's start the game. He's asleep. Sound asleep. Well, takes a little while. The quiet sound of the morning air rustling through the tops of the trees can be heard as our hero lies fast asleep upon his bed. Small grains of sand filter into a small bucket above him. The bucket drops suddenly with the weight of the sand triggering Maddog's complex new invention. And what happens next? Whoops! The sudden splash of ice-cold water has awakened Maddog from restful sleep. That's a nice invention. Stretching with sleep-filled eyes, he looks at his new clock and wonders why he ever invented it. Yeah, I wonder too. Okay, so let's get started with the game. Finally, we can do something. He walks very, very slowly. I'll switch back to slow sometimes. And I want to switch to faster now, because if not, it takes us 100 parts with this game, and I don't want to spend that much time. We have the F keys to control things here. So F2 gets you a kind of a help screen with all the modes and all the features this game has to offer you. F1 for fight mode, F2 show the screen, F3 repeat last line typed as in Sierra games, F4 and F5 save and restore games, F6 set speed, show inventory, sound on and off, restore game and quit. Okay, control and shift keys for joystick stuff, we don't need that. Okay doke. So, we want to set the speed to fast. Alright, good. Open drawer. Yeah, you have to type in this game. The drawer slides quietly open. Good. Look in drawer. The top drawer contains my clothes. Great. Look at clothes. Some old shirts and pants are neatly folded in the drawer. And anything else? Look, pants. No. But I know you have to. Doesn't say a word about the socks, but you still have to get them. And you carry them around during the whole game and wonder why you had to get them. Maddog retrieves his socks from the drawer. Okay, let's do that. Can we wear socks? There is nothing wrong with the pair I have on now. Okay, good. Wear clothes. Maddog looks over the assortment of clothing and replies, I think what I have on is fine. Well, I think he's walking around in his underwear, but okay. What do we have here? On one of the shelves rests my sword. That's good. The other shelves hold extra blankets and linens. Hey, what a neat guy. So, we should get a sword, I guess. Maddog takes his mighty sword from the bedroom shelf and admires its fine craftsmanship for a moment. Maddog then carefully sheathes its it. And we got a point! Six points for this. What else is there? Look at boots. Oh, what is that down there? A pair of working boots lie underneath the shelves. Can we get them? Shaking his head, he turns to you and says, never did like those boots. They're too heavy to lug around. Well, okay. Then you walk around in socks. Okay, there is nothing else we can do here. If you hear something in the background, that's my co-commentator Sandy, my 18-year-old cat, who loves to co-comment, but that's okay. So, nice living room. Look around. The smell of hickory smoke rises from the black cast iron stove on the east wall of the kitchen. An oak table is in the corner, and a small cabinet stands against the west wall. Good. Can we do something here? The slight scent of burning hickory wood emanates from the black iron stove, which serves as the only source of heat for the small cottage dwelling. Okay. Can we sit and share? Maddog plops himself into the swing chair and begins to rock side to side. Okay, stop. Stop rocking. Get up. Okay, good. That was fun. I never saw that before. Maddog gets to his feet feeling refreshed. A little Easter egg. Okay. What can we see here? The well-crafted hardwood cabinet sits against the west wall of Maddog's rather large kitchen. It has a small wash basin that rests on the cabinet top. Well, if this is medieval, that guy is pretty modern. Open cabinet. Okay, Maddog opens the cabinet door. Look into the cabinet. The shelves contain several old dishes. Maddog's favorite mug sits off to one side. Good, let's get it. Okay. Maddog reaches in the cabinet and takes his favorite mug. Whoa, we have a mug now, and I think F7 was the inventory. Yeah, we can always check that. So we see we wear our sword, our cup, and our socks. But we don't wear the socks. We carry them. And we carry the cup. Okay. Close cabinet. Maddog gently closes the cabinet doors. Okay. He's a neat guy. I mean, he's got fresh linen and all. Whoa, great. Look around. This is my antique shop, Maddog explains. Antiques, odds and ends, and just plain junk cover the tables and walls of the shop. A metal scale sits on the counter, and a full suit of plate armor stands against the east wall. Hey, a small mechanical device sits in the middle of the counter. Hey, can we take the armor? Might come in handy. Take armor. Maddog looks at you strangely and asks, but what if someone wanted to buy it? Well, we're going to be gone on an adventure. Who comes in to buy stuff? But okay. So we got to get this device. Look at the device. What is it? A series of gears, cranks, and pulleys make up the whole of Maddog's latest invention. It's called an automatic beer server and was built for Frank, the owner of Pete's Pub. A small lever is pulled down, which releases the arm, sliding the beer down the bar to the customer. Well, that sounds nice. Maybe we'll get to see a pub and give it to the bartender, whatever. Oh, my cat is running nuts. Get the device. Great. Okay. Maddog looks the server over and checks to make sure it's ready. Having checked it over, Maddog picks it up and carries it with him. Good. And there is a box. We should have a look in that. Open box. Maddog opens the box. Maddog looks in his money box and sees 5 gold pieces. Whoa! Let's get them. Sorry. Maddog reaches into the box and retrieves his 5 gold pieces. Whoa, we're rich. Okay, time to leave our home and go for adventuring. But we'll do that in the next video. Stay tuned.